Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. I am Mr. Prithviraj. I am your class 8 physics teacher. I hope you all are following your social distance measures so that you can stay safe. In our last class, we have completed up to our why synthetic fibers we do use over our natural fibers, right? In this class, students, we will learn one of the most interesting thing. I think this word you have heard number of times. The word is called plastic. How plastic is made up of? What are the types of plastic? What is the history of plastic? Who made it? This all stuff we will discuss in this particular time. Okay? So first thing is, plastic comes from a compound called polyester. What, students? Polyester. Let me write it. Let me write here, poly, comma, ester. It is a one word, but I have written so that you people can understand what I want to say. Poly esters. Poly means, students, a lot. I have an issue with my teeth, okay? Please pardon if any word comes wrong. Poly means a number of, okay, बहुत सारे. Ester, ester is an organic compound. Have you ever ate mango? Yes. You have it. I think you are eating. Usually, you two people eat banana as well. When these things ripening happens, you will see, you will smell a sweet smell, right? A kind of sweety smell you can feel. That sweety kind of smell which you are feeling, that is due to esters. So you need to remember, students, esters are organic chemical compounds which are usually available on whatever may be the fruits or organic things which are ripening. So scientists or lab makers, what they do? They do extract this esters. Okay? Now, how it will prepare and all we will discuss. But the main thing is the compound called polyester, and we will call them polyester. We will discuss about that. Polyester is the most commonly used synthetic fiber. Polyester fiber revolutionized the fiber industry, changed the costume culture. Fabric made from polyester fiber doesn't get wrinkled easily, it remains crisp and easily washable. Okay, a lot of things are there. Actually, when polyester entered the market, it changed the course of cotton and all. Like we people were using nylon, we people were using a lot of acrylic, which I already explained. Okay, but when polyester came, everything changed. Because with the help of polyester, you can make whatever you want. Okay, it doesn't get wrinkled, it remains stiff, it remains perfect, it is easily washable. The only problem with it is, it can easily catch fire, as like nylon. As like, you might have heard tearing, right? Tearing is a famous, like most common example of polyester. It is the most common example of a polyester. Okay? And this tearing can combine with cotton. You can combine this with cotton as well to make what, students? Terricot. What? Terricot. You can combine this wool with wool, and you can make what? Terry wool. What you can make, students? You can make terry right. Now, we will discuss how polyester is made up of, how this compound is made up of. Very important, only three lines. If you are listening carefully, you will get it. How it is made? Okay, polyester is made by reacting terephthalic acid to dimethyl ether. First, I write your name. Thank you. as you can see, terephthalic acid. Okay, terephthalic acid will be combined with a compound called dimethyl ether. Dimethyl ether. As you can see clearly, they both are combined. Now when they both are combined, they will give a compound, and this particular compound will be combined with dihydric alcohol. After combining both of them, we will combine it with dihydric alcohol, and at last we will be getting what? Polyester. Okay, students, the property polyester can be like with the help of polyester, you can make very microfibers. Microfiber means what? Very fine fiber. Okay, it is like smaller than cotton as well. You might have seen a thread more shorter than that. The diameter will be less than your thread as well. Okay, we can make that kind of compound from this polyester. Polyester can be melted and spun. The property allows fiber to convert into different shape and sizes. We can convert this into different shape and sizes. Not only cotton, not only dress, students. We can make, with the help of this, boat we can make, ropes we can make, boots we can make, shoes we can make. Okay, you know the difference between boots and shoes, right? And we can make bottles, plastic bottles, soda bottles. A lot of things we can make with the help of polyester. So now I said, with the help of this we can make plastic bottles and all. So is it only one kind of polyester is available? No. A variety of polyesters are available near us, and with the help of those polyesters we can make different kind of plastic equipments. So let me write how many kind of polyesters you can avail on the market. I erase it, okay? They all have code name, students. First is PET, second is called as well HDPE. Okay. Third is your word PVC. What? PVC. And fourth is your LDPE. Okay, and fifth one is your word PP. Fifth one is what? PP. Motor, right? Now, first, what is PET? PET means what? Polyethylene terephthalate. What? Polyethylene. Polyethylene terephthalate. Polyethylene terephthalate. This is the compound with which you can make. You can see chocolate jars in shops. You can see a lot of boxes, plastic boxes in your kitchen. You people use those old stuffs, which are visible clearly. You can see what inside out. Those clear plastics are made up of PET. Okay, then you have HDPE. These also a kind of plastic. It is called as high density polyethylene. Okay, this is called high density. How density what student? Polyethylene. Polyethylene. Then we have PVC. PVC pipes, you can see PVC pipes. Okay, PVC pipes, use PVC pipes. These are called as polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride. Okay. LDP, I don't have to write. This is low density polyethylene. This is what? Low density polyethylene. Again, the easiest format. And the last one is, not last one actually, fifth one is polypropylene. What students? Polypropylene. These are the easy one. And we have PS, the sixth one. Let me erase. Okay, here I write the sixth one. Sixth one is what? Polystyrene. Last one is what? Polystyrene students. So these are the stuffs which you need to remember, and seventh one is others. Seventh one is others, which comprises of a lot of things like others include resin. Specifically, they don't have names. They are noted with the name called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, some kind of chemical names which you don't have to know. But these six are very important. Okay, on seventh one, you can write others. Okay, so these are the types of polystyrene which is available near us. Okay, now when I said a word called plastic, students, now when I said word called plastic, before starting our this class, I said that we will learn about plastic. So plastics are coming from where? Plastics are coming from polystyrene. Okay. Okay. Now, where we can use these plastics? Where we are using these plastics? In our house, in our kitchen, in while writing, your pen is also made up of plastic. Mobile phones, most of the covers and the glass, okay, and the fine equipments and your computer domes, everything students, everything. You cannot imagine this world without plastic nowadays. Each and every stuff in this world is made up of now plastic only. So this plastic is of two types. One is linear arrangement monomers, another is crosslinked. See, you got to know what is plastic. Plastics are actually small like you can call monomers. Means we have like just now we have completed about what you call polystyrene. So when we talk about these polyesters, when these polyesters, small compounds are there, they will be chained together. How they will be chained together? They will be arranged in the manner. Suppose this is a small compound called monomer, another monomer, another. Now this is what their arrangement looks like. But when we talk about another kind of arrangement is there, that is called a cross-link arrangement. What student? Cross-link. Cross-link means they will be connected from all directions. Okay, they will be connected from all directions. So these are two kinds of plastics. And about this kind of plastics, we will learn briefly in our next class. Until then, what you need to do? You will need to practice everything about today, whatever I said about polyesters, and about types of polyesters, and activity number 7. And on note of that, I take a leave. Thank you so much.